Hi, I'm Bill, and welcome to Clean Care. In this episode, we'll cover principles of cleaning. A clean facility is important to maintain its appearance and safety, as well as contribute to its overall long-term maintenance. To remove soil from any surface will always require some combination of time, physical energy, mechanical energy, chemical energy, and temperature. Most cleaning jobs will require at least two of these properties, but you can greatly reduce one or more of them by slightly increasing another. For example, with enough time, you could remove a juice stain from a smooth surface by simply using a cloth and scrubbing it until it is gone. Alternatively, if you add just a little bit of cleaner and water, you will reduce the amount of time and physical energy needed by a huge margin. Fortunately, today we have many tools at our disposal in terms of chemistry and equipment, all designed to help reduce the amount of physical energy and time required for any given task. Cleaning has been defined as the removal of unwanted soil from any given surface. Effective cleaning takes into account the type of soil and the type of surface to be cleaned, and applying the appropriate tasks and tools to reach the desired result. Soils are categorized into two types. Organic soil includes dirt, oil, grease, food, and blood. Inorganic soil includes calcium, magnesium, and rust. Surfaces also fall into two categories. Resilient surfaces relate mostly to floors and include vinyl, linoleum, rubber, and wood. Non-resilient surfaces would include concrete, ceramics, stone, and brick. It's important to consider both the surface and the soil type, as some cleaning agents can be corrosive if used on the wrong surface. For example, a caustic, such as a hydrochloric acid, might be suitable for removing soil from some surfaces, but may cause damage if used to clean a painted or a finished surface. There are four ways that cleaning can take place. Each action is useful in different circumstances, although cleaning by detergency aided by mechanical action is by far the most common in today's environment. Cleaning by solvency involves applying a solvent solution to oil-based organic soil. Over time, the soil particles are dissolved and distributed throughout the solution. When the solution is removed, the soil is removed along with it. Solvents are usually organic-based and include mineral spirits, chlorinated solvents, and delimonene. Cleaning by detergency involves applying a detergent to the surface. These solutions include surfactants, soil suspenders, wetting agents, and water softeners. With time, soil particles are lifted and suspended in the solution until wiped away. Water is the most common carrying agent, and the pH of the detergent solution is usually neutral to moderately alkaline. Cleaning by chemical reaction involves applying a chemical-based solution to soil that is not affected by solvent or detergent. The chemical is usually acidic and chemically changes the composition of the soil, which causes it to detach from the surface. This is effective for removing non-organic, insoluble soils, such as magnesium, calcium, and iron, from non-resilient surfaces, such as toilets, urinals, and showers. Cleaning by mechanical action can include simple tasks like sweeping debris with a broom, using an abrasive pad to scrub a surface, or even sandblasting. This type of cleaning is most effective when used in combination with a chemical program. The pH of a cleaning agent has a significant effect on the surfaces that are cleaned, so it is important to have an understanding of the chemicals that you're using. pH is simply potential of hydrogen in a solution and will determine how acidic or alkaline a liquid is. The pH of pure water is 7 and is considered neutral. Highly acidic solutions will have a high concentration of hydrogen ions, and alkaline solutions will have a low concentration of hydrogen ions. The pH scale is not linear like the increments on a ruler, but instead is a logarithmic scale where each value increases by a magnitude of 10. A solution with a pH of 8 is 10 times more alkali than a neutral solution, or pure water. And a solution with a pH of 9 is 100 times more alkaline than water. As you move up to the stronger alkaline solutions, the difference will add up quickly. A floor stripper with a pH of 13 will be 1 million times more alkaline than water. The same principles apply to acids as well. Mixing an acid and an alkali together can cancel out and neutralize the effects of the other. Alkaline solutions are effective in cleaning oil-based organic soil from surfaces. Acidic solutions are effective for cleaning mineral-based inorganic soils. It's important to consider the pH and the surface, since high pH cleaners can easily remove paint from walls and strip the protective coating off of other surfaces. This is why alkaline cleaners are used in floor stripping. Since this process leaves an alkali residue, the floor will have to be neutralized and tested before continuing. Modern cleaning chemical solutions, for the most part, are made up of synthetic detergents, as they are better cleaners and don't leave an alkali residue like soap does. Synthetic detergents have several basic ingredients: surfactants, builders, chelating agents, and diluents. Surfactants are the soil suspenders, emulsifiers, and wetting agents that lower the surface tension of water, essentially making the water wetter. A builder is a phosphate, caustic, or metasilicate substance that increases or builds the pH of a cleaner. A chelating agent, or sequestrant, is a water softener which helps increase the detergent's effectiveness in hard water. Diluent is a carrier or vehicle. Water is the most common diluent in liquids. Salt and ash are the most common in powders. These ingredients will make a good basic cleaner, but for specific tasks, a specialized formula is needed. To construct a degreaser, a solvent like delimonene is added. To make a germicide, a phenol, or quat, or hydrogen peroxide is added. And to make a floor stripper, ammonia, amine, or solvent is added to the synthetic detergent. Although this technical information is not necessary to get the job done, we hope that this video has given you a good understanding of some of the chemistry and principles that make effective cleaning possible. If you found this video useful, hit like. To keep up to date with clean care, please subscribe. And for the widest selection of products, low prices, and same-day shipping, explore our website below. Thanks for watching.